On my last job, the hydraulic arms on the tractor were having some difficulty lifting the implement. This is a problem that's been slowly growing for some time, so it's been giving me some warning. And the problem is the hydraulic pump located right here has started to leak. And specifically, it's been leaking out the adjustment right here. On the left side is the actual hydraulic pump, which is a vane style pump on the 1953 Golden Jubilee and then the 54 NAA model. And you can see there's an attachment here to the left. This is the cable that goes up and connects into the proof meter up here on the dash. The right side of the sub-assembly is an adjustable valve, which they called Hytrol. Basically, with the vane style pump, one interesting advantage to it is that you can control the gallons per minute, and that control is right here. All the way out is minimum, give you, a fraction of a gallon per minute, and then you can adjust it in to give up to about 5 gallons per minute of flow. This is really useful for tuning the tractor to different implement needs. I was able to minimize the leaks coming out of that adjuster by actually backing it all the way up to hitting the dipstick for the engine oil. And that was fine for my needs, but those leaks have increased over time. It's easy to see when the tractor's running. When I would let it set, there would be a decent amount of hydraulic fluid down here in the drip pan. So it's time to take care of that. That's what I'm going to do now. And rather than rebuild this vintage vane pump, because I use my tractor a lot, I'd like to convert it to a modern style gear-based pump, which is what we're going to do here. Here's a simple comparison diagram of different types of hydraulic pumps. Again, the 53 and 1954 Fords featured the variable displacement vane style pumps. Later Fords converted over to a piston based pump when they went to the 600 series tractors. But today, most common is you'll find gear based oil pumps. This would be an external gear based pump, and then you can have the internal gear based as well. They're simple, they're reliable, they are fixed displacement, so give up that flexibility that the vane offers, but you get better reliability with the gear style pump. So that's what I'm interested in converting over to. I have some of the original literature on the tractor here as well. So this is the Hytrol control right here. They're showing the adjustment where you can adjust down to a nominal level of, they're saying 2.5 or 2.25 gallons per minute up to 5 gallons per minute right there. And then in the owner's manual for the tractor, they have a nice illustration of an exploded diagram of that vane style pump. So this is from the inside looking out. Here's the engine camshaft right here. So we have the camshaft gear driving the pump right here, meshing in. Here's the vanes on the rotor, and then the adjustable flow rate control right here, where as you turn it in, you get maximum flow, turn it out, you get minimum flow. So this entire assembly we'll remove from the tractor and then replace it with a more modern variant. Okay, this is exciting. We have a delivery from Windy Ridge Farm and Machine. Got a little gasket there. And it's an entire replacement kit for Ford tractors. Here's our fixed displacement gear pump, spec'd out at 6.7 gallons per minute at 2000 RPM on the engine. So it's going to feature the pump as well as an adapter plate. all the parts we need to make this happen. There's the gear mesh. There's where the proof meter will attach. There's a pump. Very nice, it's already painted in red. Okay, so let's take the old pump off and get started. Okay, first step is to remove the proof meter cable over here. From the factory, these came with two steel hydraulic lines. This particular tractor, one of the lines here has been replaced with a more modern flex line. So got one of each. So that'll be interesting in installing the new pump because we'll have to attach the lines in two different ways. Okay, here we can see the two pumps side by side with the original vane pump up here and the newer gear pump down here. So the Ford pump had both the inlet and the outlet on the bottom. We can see what looked like it was a 1/4-inch line coming in here and then a 3/8-inch line in here. Those, again, from the factory would have been steel hard lines. And then on mine, one of those must have failed and was replaced with a flexible hydraulic line on the 1/4-inch side. On the replacement pump, there basically has an inlet and an outlet on opposite sides up here on the top and then on the bottom. And those have these fittings that have integrated O-rings. So it's an SAE
number 6 and an SAE number 8. And the kit comes with adapters here, which is nice. So those adapters can get over to the pipe thread, the NPT thread for the quarter inch and the 3/8 inch if you have, you know, soft hydraulic lines. Or in the case of mine, where I have one of each, I need to do a modification on the other one. And that's what this piece is right here. So this will have a what's known as a versaflange on one side. I can cut one of my hoses, the rigid hoses, short, and then install that across it, and then use a flex line for getting into the pump. And that has to wrap around the top like that with the right angle side, and then into the SAE-8, which is what we see right there. So we'll get the pump mounted up first, and then we'll start plumbing all this in.
Okay, we have to get the cable drive bushing off the old pump. There's a washer on there. Okay, the new pump has a factory bolt in it for shipping. Here's the slotted screw from the old pump on the cable drive. It has a washer underneath too. Seated in there, and inside that slot will be the adapter for the cable drive. Okay, now we can reconnect the proof meter drive. Let's try to get that aligned first. I can take off this protective cap here. And that is going to get a right angle fitting, which would be the SAE 8. Let's keep that loose for now. The bottom fitting is going to get a swivel adapter, which is the SAE 6, and we'll keep that loose as well for now.
Okay, here's where the hydraulic send and return lines enter the bottom of the tractor. I'm going to replace the newer soft line in this one. I really don't know how old it is, so step one is to remove that. This is a pipe thread, so it's going to be pretty well on there. Again, these are pipe threads, so I have some pipe dope on them to help seal all but the last couple threads. This is a 1/4 inch fitting, so I have a 9/16 wrench. Okay, so there's one of the two connections in the rear, a flexible hose, and that will ultimately connect right up into the underside right here, the pump. Before we do that, the hard line that's left over, the flange on it, that needs to be cut back somewhere about in here so that we can adapt it to the other flexible line, which will reach up around the top, connect to the top of the pump. Okay, I've temporarily connected the top of the pump with the new flex line that comes down to this VersaFlare and wedged up the old hard line here. So we can mark that where the old hard line needs to be cut. There's definitely a kink in the line right here. So we're going to have to come back up to about here to make the cut.
Okay, here's the VersaFlare on there. It's got the pipe all the way to the end. Loosely connect this right now. Let's keep that from dripping. Okay, we're on the home stretch here. We just need to put in two hoses into the pump for good. These swivel adapters make things really easy. Get aligned. I feel like this is maybe a good idea to try to help prime the pump just by pouring some hydraulic fluid into the top. Okay, we'll put this angle piece on. I think on mine it's going to be angled slightly rearward. Got some period correct tie wraps. Okay, that should be it. Got all the fittings tightened up and the hose is laced up. Coming on back to the rear connections here. In the future, I might just replace that other hard line with the adapter with a hose. I'd have to come back here and tap out the connection. Future project, but for now, we'll just see how this works. I fire it up, test it out, see if we have any leaks.
good. No leaks. Let's go do some work.
Okay, quick little diversion. We've got to get gussied up here to do some parade duty. Okay, that was pretty fun. In fact, even won an award. Best tractor in the parade. The old girl still has it. Okay, real happy with it. Pump is working perfectly, and there's not a single drop on the ground from either running or sitting. So all these connections are working perfectly. The one thing I did notice is that on the smaller line here, a little bit of surging when it was under heavy loads. I might swap that out for a little larger line. That has nothing to do with the pump. That was the original owner of the tractor had used a quarter inch line. So I'm going to try a 3/8 inch line here and see if that makes any bit of a difference. I can show you the surging that was happening with that. Hydraulic hose is not my expertise, but I think I got the right thing. I went online to discounthydraulichose.com, and you can put together an assembly up there. So this is what they sent me. I got the next size up in hose, which is 3/8 inch hydraulics tough, and I have different fittings on each end. So there's an MP 06 on one end and an 04 on the other, so that should help me adapt between what was threaded on the tractor with pipe thread and then over to the pump. I had to go a little shorter on this because I'll show you there is one issue where this is going to interface with the tractor. So over here where the hard line comes in, as well as the flexible hose. There's not a lot of space between the two, so I'm going to have to extend out the smaller hose just a few inches to get beyond the other connection. And so because of that, I'll have a little bit shorter hose. And at the other end, where it interfaces with the pump, I'm going to place one of these swivel adapters, which has the O-ring on the other side. So that allow me to, you know, both tighten up the connection and change to the O-ring to go into the pump. Okay, I put the next size up adapter here into the pump.
That's a wrap for the hydraulic upgrade and repair. Really happy with the outcome. And if you have similar needs for your Ford tractor, I highly recommend checking out Windy Ridge Farm and Machine. Call them up and they can help get your problem sorted out. And very lastly, I'll just need to figure out what to do with this original vintage pump. Maybe I'll put it on eBay or something like that, pass it on down the line to someone that can use something like that. So hopefully you found this useful. Talk to you later.